Good morning, children. Welcome back to our English class. Today, we discuss the poem "Limes Written in Early Spring" by the master celebrated poet of nature, William Wordsworth. William Wordsworth is one of the major figures in the history of English literature. He was born on 7 April 1770 in Cockermouth, United Kingdom. In collaboration with his friend Samuel Taylor Coleridge, he published a collection of poems titled Lyrical Ballads in 1798, which marked the beginning of Romantic Age in English literature. His semi-autobiographical work, The Prelude, is considered to be his masterpiece. He was Britain's poet laureate from 1843 until his death. He passed away on 23rd April 1850. Let us have a short analysis of the poem. Limes Written in Early Spring is a poem which celebrates the relationship between man and nature. Written by the most celebrated poet of nature, William Wordsworth. The poet rejoices in the sights and sounds of the nature and at the same time laments on what man has made of man. The poet once sits in the grove in a very calm and relaxed mood. He hears loads of various sounds and songs. He finds solace and becomes much pleased in the songs of birds and music of the woods. At the same time, some woeful thoughts come to his mind and he becomes pensive. He sees primrose, periwinkle make wreaths in the bower there. Believes that every flower enjoys the air it breathes. The birds around him express their thrill of pleasure by hopping and playing in the grove. He also notices the budding twigs spread out their tender leaves to catch the breezy air. In short, the poet sees the thrilling sights and hears pleasant songs in everything he looks at in the grove, and he experiences the utmost pleasure of the world of nature. But when he thinks of the human world, he becomes very sad. What man has done to the mankind as well as to nature makes him uneasy and unpleasant. The coexistence in the perfect harmony is the holy plan of nature. The poet realizes that humans do all atrocities among themselves and cruelties to nature by destroying the ecosystem. They create discord, disharmony, and fight and kill themselves. All these wrongdoings are against the holy plan of nature. Now you see the activity number 1 given in the page number 32. You have to do a work. What may be the thoughts of the poet about the human world? See here, humans do all atrocities among themselves and they create discord and disharmony. They fight and kill themselves. All these wrongdoings are against the holy plan of nature. In the world of nature, everything coexists in perfect harmony. Humans not only harm themselves, but also destroy nature. They demolish the ecosystem to satisfy their greed. They destroy forests, pollute air and water. They exploit natural resources without least considering the other creatures on the earth, as well as ignoring their own future generation. They are selfish. This poem is said to have the historical background of the French Revolution and its associated conflicts and commotion. Apart from the natural world, human world is full of pains and problems of self-creation. See the poetic devices used by the poet here. The first one, an example for personification. What do you mean by personification? Giving an animal quality to an inanimate object. Here, the poet addresses the nature by calling it as her. To her fair works did nature link. Another example, and it is my faith that every flower enjoys the air it breathes. So flower enjoys the air it breathes. Every flower enjoys the air it breathes. The budding twigs spread out their fan to catch the breezy air. All these activities can be done by a living being, but the poet is giving such activity to an inanimate objects. Visual images. Example, birds around me hopped and played. Another example, grove, green bower, the flowers, primrose and periwinkle, budding twigs. So the images that we see with our sensory organ eye. Another example for auditory image. Image, I heard 1,000 blended notes. Here poet is hearing a mixed sounds while sitting in the grove. So the image that one can hear. Alliteration. What do you mean by alliteration? The repetition of initial consonant sounds in the same line of the poem. Example, man has made of man. What man has made of man. Here M is repeated 3 times. Next one, hyperbole is an exaggerated narration. Narrates a thing in an exaggerated way. I heard 1,000 blended notes. Then next thing, rhyming words. Can you find out the rhyming words in the first stanza of the poem? Which are the words that rhyme each other? In the first line, notes, and in the third line, thoughts, ends with the same sound S. And see the second line and fourth line. These lines reclined mind. These words ends with the same sound D. So they rhyme each other. So can you guess the rhyme scheme of this poem? First one, we can give the name A. Second line, B. Third line, A. Fourth line, B. So the rhyme scheme is A, B, A, B. Thanks for watching. Bye.